And welcome back, everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for the Vi Prologue for the Path of Champions. So we did Jinx, we did Jace. Maybe we did them a little bit out of order because you're probably doing them, you know, going Jinx to Vi and stuff. But we're going to head on over and do Vi's Prologue now. We're planning on doing all five Prologues tonight. Let's see what we got for Vi. So this is, you know, first time checking out the deck. Looks like, you know, some okay cards, but this looks like a little bit of a weaker deck. So, you know, that's going to be how that is. Okay, so there's our deck for Vi. All right, so let's try out this one. So it looks like now Vi's kind of the opposite of, you know, with Jinx, you went to go travel to fight Vi at the very end. And it looks like with Vi, you're going to travel to fight Jinx at the very end.
Another boring day on the beat. Piltover rarely gets action. It's all walking, no scrapping. But then...
Vi! Vi!
Hey, Tremors, what's going on?
We got trouble. Some mechanical maniacs tearing up the Undercity. Captain wants you on the scene.
Oh, sounds like my kind of work.
The old punching grounds. All right, we're going to the Undercity, the old punching grounds. All right, looks like we're eventually getting to Jinx. Through Victor. All right, we got the Chempunk Pickpocket. Peering into an alley, you spot a familiar face doing his best to hide his coin grabber. Maybe he can point you in the right direction. All right, looks like we're finding some trouble. Chempunk Pickpocket. Pickpocket is really fun to say. Like, that's like, there's some strong consonants in there. It's just a good quality word. Pickpocket. Who'd you get the gear from, kid? Who's asking? You an enforcer? I am, but I ain't asking.
A foray into the field? How exciting! Putting study into practice. You want tanks? You want burners? Huh?
I can do this.
Okay. We're looking good, looking good. So at the beginning of the prologue, pretty easy. They, you know, start with one less mana than you, and also one less card.
Take from the rich, give to me.
Take from the rich, give to me. That's the pickpocket.
Just as I hypothesized.
I hope this works.
Almost got him. All right, got to do 3 more points of damage. Hey, there's Vi. Let's play a little chump one. Okay, so we could easily attack for lethal, or we could play Vi. I think we should play Vi.
Stands for violence. This is Tin Skull territory.
Ooh, the Tin Skull boss. Vi's taking down the boss. You think Vi's ever said that, like, after knocking somebody out? And that's a knockout. Alright, not the best rewards to put in here. Yeah, I don't know if I love any of these cards. Alright, so this Klaxon Lombot, this is a new card that's just for the prologue, and, you know, just for these Path of Champions. You know, this isn't a collectible card. So it's a 3-mana 1-1. We would make it a 3-1. So 3-mana 3-1 that then creates a 1-mana 3-2. So for 4-mana, you get a 3-1 and a 3-2. You know, that's basically like that card that just got nerfed. You know, y'all know what I'm talking about, from Bandle City. Basically that, 4-mana for a 3-1 and a 3-2. That's not too bad, but I'm going to just take Pseudo. I don't know why. I kind of feel like I'd rather just have Pseudo. Ooh, and we get a new power. I think it's more. Got him. When you cast a spell, deal 1 to the enemy Nexus. Cards you draw cost one less this round, and round start grant the weakest ally +1/+1. All pretty good. I like things costing less. Our deck is kind of expensive, so I do like things costing less, but also dealing one to the enemy nexus is always good. Get some spell burn. We'll go and do quick draw. That's a new power. I haven't seen that one before. The first one costs 3. And then the second one costs 1. For the 2/4s. The 3/1 and the 3/2. Okay, we'll send those back. Keep the astute academic and always keep a mystic shot. Card's pretty good. A likely story. So now this costs 1. Yeah, we can play it.
The sea tells me all I need.
Dinobot. We just made this Poro Cannon cost 0 instead of 0. We'll get our own Poros.
Safety first.
My right. Alright, Vi's growing. Oh, I should have changed to the new Vi. Alright, so now it's 1 mana deal 3. Okay. So Vi doesn't count herself, right? Like, if we play this Vi next round... Oh, we're not going to be able to play Vi next round anyway. We have 4 mana. They do get to create these ignitions. Oh, but our veteran investigator can just trade with the ballistic bot. So now pseudo cost 0. That's the 6 mana card. Ouch.
Here comes the punchline. Suit up and move out.
Get him, Vi. Oh, Rising Spell Force. That's gonna have these two trade. We're honestly not doing that great. We're not doing that great.
How can I help?
Okay, we got a couple of good elusives, though. So it looks like they haven't played anything the last two rounds that have been scary at all. Alright, they're down to 4. Yeah! Clump Lump. Oh, wow, that could be good. They get an 8-8. That's pretty good. I do not want to take 8. No, thank you. Okay, so we should still have this because we got our two elusives. They can't block. And they're down to 2. Thanks to those puff caps. Alright. That was looking bad there for a second. Once they kill my Vi. Okay, so we don't need to make things cost any less, right? So let's go ahead and just take this like Academy Protege. Because we need more bodies, as we saw there. +3/+1 on that thing, so it's going to be a 6/2. 6/2 quick attack. Potentially 1 mana if we draw it. Reward. We get some reinforcements. Good. Okay, who do we want to be our second champion? Fizz, Ash, or Riven? I kind of think Riven. Yeah, Riven's going to get us a couple other bodies. Like, Riven being able to give Vi Overwhelm could be really nice. Okay, so this time... Alright, we're going to go this way. This time, let's, you know, remember to go to the epic question or exclamation point afterwards. We got Riven Vi. Whoa, got a donation! Boo! Thank you so much for the new cosmetics. Thank you so much. Alright, getting our goal started. Oh, that reminded me. Oh, I didn't change out my Vi to be the new Vi. Alright, that's alright. Alright, well, I'll do that right after this game. I'll remember to do it. Gotta see that bling. Thank you, Boo. And yeah, so anybody watching later on YouTube, if you are enjoying the videos and want to help support purchasing all the expensive cosmetics that Riot has, we're doing our cosmetics goal here. And there's a donation link down below in the video description, if you're so inclined. So they got a 2-3 lifesteal, so we'll play our 3-1 that can go ahead and tussle with that. Alright, so let's get Astute Academic in play first, and then Veteran Investigator, so we both draw a card. And now we drew Boom Crew Rookie, so we can play that also. And... I don't know if this is really that great of an attack, but we're going to attack. See how they block. Okay, so they're keeping the lifesteal alive, unfortunately. There. Okay. They're down to 13. Zero mana suit up. Oh, that's burst speed. I can't respond to that with the suit up. Okay, let's. So that thing's an elusive. Let's go and play our own elusive to be able to block it.
This is a no-fly zone.
I've never heard the era not say that. This is a no-fly zone with blocking. Because I don't think I've ever really blocked that card too much. Alright, so we did get the Overwhelm Blade Fragment.
Vi stands for
Yeah, so Vi doesn't increase by itself. Alright, so I'll use Overwhelm next round. Because Vi will be larger next round and probably not going against 4 health. Turn the 1-1 into a 4-4.
Safety disengaged.
And now overwhelmed by.
I don't need a freeze.
I've licked my wounds too long.
Alright, so that does 2 to the Vi, but Vi is tough. The Vi can survive 2 damage. The Vi will not level up, but still all that overwhelmed damage comes through. And finishes it out. So moving right along in our quest. Okay. I think we're going to buff up this Rune Weaver. Might's pretty nice, but again, like, we can just, you know, basically get the same thing from the Reforged tokens. And so I like this, you know, getting a 4-4 Rune Weaver. I'm liking that. Let's go and buff up Runeweaver. Okay, now let's go up to the exclamation point. Okay, so now we get the special delivery. A courier approaches, parcel in hand. It's from Chief Mechanist Zevi. Figured you could use a little gauntlet upgrade. Good luck out there. Thanks, Zevi. So now whenever Vi is summoned, we're going to create the Piltover Enforcer in hand. Which is 2 mana, grants an allied champion +4/+4, then it strikes the strongest enemy. Or 3 mana, okay, but still, 3 mana, grant Vi +4/+4. That's a little overkill. We'll travel to the healer. Oh, we need to not... Wait. Okay, because I think I healed before. So, do we need to not heal and then also finish at 30 to get S skill? Maybe, but I don't really know how we're finishing at 30 anyway, so we'll just go ahead and heal. Yeah, those are some new gloves. No, I didn't see the updated Deep Rock Galactic notes. No, I didn't. What's new with Deep Rock Galactic? What is this? Each time? Each round, the first time the foe draws a card, they create a fleeting copy of it in hand. That's pretty good. I'm going to just send everything back. I don't think there's... Like, these are cards that I want to draw later on. They're not Vi. They're not Riven.
If you tear down half the city, Victor, you know I'm going to come knocking.
Enough of you two! I just want to be left in peace!
You too?
Yeah, you too.
What can I say? I'm an adaptable guy. Try to keep up!
Well, you're not adapting too well to this situation. Making Portal Cannon cause zero?
Happy to do whatever's needed.
Alright, well, I need you to block my 4-4, I guess. Oh, MK2. So they just started with MK2 because they haven't played an MK1 yet. So they just started the game with an MK2. That's new. Alright, we got the Overwhelm Blade Fragment. Good, good.
The same calling card from our other case.
Can we get another Vi? No. Alright, we can play one mana Rune Weaver. So now we have three mana. So we can play all three of these. And we'll go ahead and just put it on the Riven.
The power of the written word.
So quick attack there, +2/+0 here. Overwhelm. I guess. Also on you. Because you assumed the 3/3 would block the 4/1.
Make these pieces whole.
They had the Jinx emote whenever we leveled up our champion. Calculated creation. Ow. One damage. Alright, so we can give the Blade of the Exile to Vi. We should definitely play this Piltover Enforcer card. I mean, I guess we could put it on Riven. Yeah, let's give Riven +4/+4. Oh, but then because Riven's ability gives another +4. That's awesome. Yeah, you cost one mana and you're just like a 6/2 quick attack. I guess we'll play you.
Another brilliant design. Electroplating completed.
Alright, Victor. You are going down. For your crimes against humanity.
That's how we do it. Vi stands for victory.
GG's. Okay, so Twitch now has global League of Legends emotes. That's cool. There's a Caitlyn, Poro. I know, I've never seen those. Alright, so Suda brings along a Poro. Eh. So that thing can be Quick Attack. Eh. This thing can be Overwhelm. Don't love any of these. Yeah, I don't really love any of these. I guess... Sudo gets a Poro? Yeah, I guess Sudo just brings a Poro along. All right, Vi's choice. So now that we defeated Vi.
Program how to not get your butt kicked, Victor.
All for Victor.
Oh, you got my stuff back.
Wait, what? You were behind this?
Actually, it was all Fishbone's idea. He was all,
if you lead Vi down here, she'll beat up that metal man and we'll get our friends back.
He's so smart. So, can I have my stuff back? Can I, please?
I don't know, Jinx.
We got a decision to make. Confiscate Jinx's weapons or return Jinx's weapons. So, and then of course this will determine how our story plays out. So do you want our allies to have +1/+0 or enemies to have -1/-0? We'll go ahead, Jinx, we'll go ahead and give you your weapons back. Go ahead, Jinx. You can have fun. When any unit is summoned, shuffle its stats. Bar fight. Alright, we need to switch out Vi's. I guess we can switch out Riven's also. But yeah, we gotta get the Gilded Vi. Brand new Vi art. That we just spent our cosmetic money on. Okay. PNZ Bilgewater. That little tiny shrimp and those huge, you know, gauntlets. Go crack some skulls. Anyway, this looks like a pretty good hand. I'll go and keep these two drops that have been buffed up. And of course we'll keep Vi. You got that look on your face. Trouble brewing, eh? Can't get anything past you. You seen Jinx anywhere? Oh no. Jinx might have gone off the reservation after we gave Jinx all of her fun little toys and weapons back. Okay, so we're gonna reforge. And so yeah, it gets shuffled. The stats get shuffled. It's a 6-3 now instead of a 4-4. I guess whenever you play a 1-1, it can't really get shuffled.
This is a real spin to win.
Safety mode. Didn't build one.
Okay, so we have quick attack this time.
First big mission.
Hey, we got a 2-3. We'll go and better investigator.
No one knows these streets like me.
Ah, 2-5.
Two lefts, then a right. Take it through this way.
All right, getting rid of this slot bot. Sorry, slot bot. That's crazy. Look at this. That is crazy. So Vi would be an 8-4, but I guess the stats are gonna get shuffled.
Put a spring in your step and stars in your eyes.
Oh, 9-4. Okay, we're getting some good, some perfectly fine shuffling going on. Yeah, that thing's slow. Alright, doing this to make it 10 for Vi.
Jordan. Trouble coming at ya.
Time to go.
Just so we can see Vi's level up animation, because new Vi has new level up animation.
Yeah.
Let me finish this piece of shrimp first. That's so good.
Stands for victory.
Alright, what do we want? I think we want, five mana Jade Darter. That's not bad, but I really like Station Archivist. And we can give Station Archivist Challenger. We're going to go ahead and do that. All right, so we got Station Archivist Challenger. All right, we can buy stuff from the shop. They let us buy everything. All right, so Vi's now going to have minus one cost. Gotcha has minus one cost. And the Astute Academic has Challenger. I get to buy everything. So now we can either go just heal and then straight to Jinx, or we can go this way and get that exclamation mark. And then we won't heal Rexia. Yeah, then it's just going to go straight there. I think our deck's probably good. You know, like, this is just like the little prologue and stuff. I think our deck's probably pretty good. I don't think we don't really need to improve it, but if you know, if you want to improve your deck, you can always go through that. Okay, Riven and Vi. So if the foe has the attack token, it creates a super mega death rocket in hand. Every time they have the attack token, they get a super mega death rocket? That's crazy. All right, you go away, you go away, you go away, you come back. You can kill a Jinx. Eh, still go away. All right. I just want to draw the gotcha, so it's zero mana. Let me draw it.
Ah, you're here. Ah, Fishbones was all like, where's Vi? She's so cool. And also, she saved me.
Aww.
Come on, kiddo. You gotta crank it down a bunch. You're blowing everything up.
Ah, you noticed. I'm best.
My books. Hope that's all right. You're disrupting my research.
I don't think staying at 30 health is gonna really be a realistic thing with them creating these super mega death rockets every round, or you know, every time they have the attack token. So we'll just go ahead and go and block that O2. Okay, so quick attacks our blade fragment. That quick attack always goes good with challengers. All right, we get round three Vi.
Here comes the punchline.
Because it costs one from that ancient coin that it has, then also it costs one because cards that we draw cost one per turn. Yeah, super mega death rockets are real. Yeah, those are real good.
A keen mind is my greatest weapon.
Huh. Good luck punching.
Alright, so they're not playing Jinx yet. +4/+4. But unfortunately, that only means a 9/8. Not quite. 10. You know, not quite enough to level up. And boom goes the dynamite.
A little attack for a lot of pow.
I'm cold, I'm hungry, and there's rocks in me boots.
So just play this thing, cost zero, we'll be able to get our Reforged token right back. Yeah.
A key mind is my greatest weapon.
Huh. Good luck punching with that.
I wish I could make the Poro a 4/4.
Suit up and move.
Might as well play it while it costs zero. We get Overwhelm? Yes, we did. There's Overwhelm. All right, Vi's leveled up.
That's how we do it.
Oh, That's such a good level up animation. Dude, Riot has been crushing it with these different cosmetics. Alright, no more fun smoke for you. I forgot the thing was going to be one mana. Maybe I should play it.
Okay, okay, okay. I'll turn myself. Soink! Sorry, still got a couple more blues to boom.
Yeah, Jinx ain't turning herself in. Okay, so we're gonna have 17 cards left. Or some mushroom clouds.
Oh, that's a harvest right there.
Hey, what's up, Pants? Yeah, definitely taking donation decks for the new cards. You've heard of Doom and Gloom. How about Boom and Doom? Definitely getting our fair share of Boom in here. All right, so gonna be trying to make the Blade of the Exile to give to Vi this round. That's the plan. Right, they still haven't played Jinx at all. Do you want to play Jinx? Alright, so we're going to give... it doesn't really matter who we give plus 2, plus 0. I guess we'll give the weakest thing plus 2, plus 0. We'll give the quick attack to the thing with the least health. And now our Blade of the Exile on Vi. So 17-7 Overwhelm. There's Jinx.
Victory.
So they still says spend mana in labs. That should say like in Path of Champions.
Okay, I'm done. That was fun. Hey, you wanna hug it out?
Aw.
Sure. With family like you, who needs enemies?
All right, so that's Vi's prologue complete, adventure complete. We get that 50 reputation for finishing that out. Yeah, still a skill, always a skill. But, we did take a bunch of damage against Vi with those Super Mega Death Rockets. This one's got to be really hard to get an S skill on whenever they're making the Super Mega Death Rockets. Like, how are we finishing it with 30 health, right? That's got to be pretty tough, so... rank up ready. All right, studded leather, plus one, plus one. Okay. Very good. So now whenever we continue on with Vi in the just other adventures, Vi will have plus one, plus one for finishing that prologue. All right, so there we go. There was Vi's prologue. Another great one. These comics they have in here are really cool to go along with them. Man, I could just sit here and play these all day, and I'm sure some of y'all do. So let me know in the comments down below, which one's your favorite champions, if you've done anything cool, anything you really like about these Path of Champions, or any of them you want to see, like which ones do you want to see me play, let me know. But that's going to be it here for Vi's Prologue. So as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.